mute on this.
There we go. Okay. It was my microphone here. Let me turn that up a little bit. Make sure everybody can hear me. My name is David Clausen with English-Quickly.com. And once a week, I do a live broadcast where I take the best from movies, music, and different things. Okay. And so I take music, travel, books, infographics, things that have been popular during the week. And then we can learn some English from it, things that we like and that we enjoy and stuff. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to share my screen with everyone. So let me click that here, make sure that it's working. Present to everyone. And let me go over and just make sure. And what I do to make it interactive, I have a Skype account. And during broadcast here or during the lesson, feel free to call me. My Skype number is dclausen_2. That's dclausen_2 right here. So hopefully you can see that. If you have a question during the week, during the broadcast, feel free to give me a call. I'm online and just taking a look to see if anybody has any questions for that before I get started. I am broadcasting from the United States in the state of Colorado here, and I'm just outside of Denver in a town called Golden. So glad you can see this. I hope you learned a lot of English. Let me double check, make sure everything is going well. Okay, I think we are doing well. And so let's get started. I'm going to start with the number one movie of the week, but we have done this a couple weeks ago, The Hunger Games: Mockingjay. So I've done that, and I actually have done Penguins of Madagascar. I did Horrible Bosses. So today, we're going to learn about Big Hero 6, which has already made $177 million in 5 weeks. So, not bad for a fun little movie that comes from Disney. And the movie, you can see here, it's a what they call 3D computer animated superhero action comedy drama film. So it has, you know, it's an animation and it's action. So, you know, where there's fighting and tenseness and fun stuff going on, but it's a comedy drama at the same time. And what it is it's a boy who's really good at robots. So the film tells the story of a young robotics. So this would be a robot prodigy. Prodigy is somebody who's a genius, very smart, named Hiro Hamada, who forms a superhero team to combat a masked villain. So villain is a bad person, somebody who's very bad. So they're going to go get the bad person. Let me show you a trailer, we call that, a movie trailer, when you get a preview or an idea from it. And I'm going to give you a little tip. I'm going to go back. And what I did was I typed in Big Hero 6 trailer. So when you want to learn English, try this technique. It works really well. You know, you'll get the normal trailer, like here's the official U.S. trailer. But what's good to do is, for your English, you click filters. So you click filters here, and there's this part where it says subtitles or closed caption. You click that on YouTube, and now it'll give you the videos that have English writing underneath. So I picked this one. You can, you know, like this one has English and French subtitles. You know, I take a look. This is in Japanese. But this way, if you're watching movies, when you have this CC down below, closed caption, you can then watch and see the English. So if I click on it, we'll have to go through the ad here a little bit. So this is a movie made by Disney. And what's cool is that you can, when you fast forward, here is the closed caption or the English words. We're under attack from a supervillain. How cool. So that's the main character that we learned about, with his name, Hiro Hamada, who's the young robotics genius or prodigy. And that's his, one of his robots, or I haven't seen the movie, so I don't know, but that he uses to help out. So it's a fun little robotic movie that you'll have to check out. So far, you know, the budget or how much money it's made is $165 million, and it's already made $278, and that keeps going up. We can see it going more and more. It was released or let go or started on October 23rd, 2014. So if you want to check out some of the English, it's good because you can take a look at different languages, you know, where you might be able to, if you're confused with some words, then you can click on the language of your choice and, you know, get an idea. And it's a, you know, kind of a fun way to learn English from movies and stuff. I'm going to put that down below this video, the link. That way you can learn it yourself. You know, when you have time, the link will pop up and you just click it, and then you can learn from it. And I'll do it with the other things that we cover in this English video and stuff. So good. All right. So that's Big Hero 6 from movies. Now, the Billboard comes out with the Hot 100, the most popular songs. And most of these songs I've talked about before in other videos. Blank Space by Taylor Swift is number one right now. Take Me to Church, I've covered a couple weeks ago. Uptown Funk. But here's a new one called Thinking Out Loud by Ed Sheeran, which is women are gonna love it because it's a love story. So here is the single, and what the singer wanted was a walking down the aisle song for a wedding. And you'll hear that idiom, walking down the aisle. So if I type that in, walking down the aisle. And for those of you who are here live, if you have a question, just dclawson_2 at Skype. So if I type in walking down the aisle, you know, that's what they're talking about in a wedding. And when you hear some of the lyrics, the words of the song. So when your legs don't work like they used to before,
and I can't sweep you off of your feet.
And I can't sweep you off of your feet. That's an English idiom. To sweep you off your feet is to impress somebody. So let's do that. Sweep you off your feet. You know, that's kind of to impress somebody, to make a good impression. Okay, when I can't sweep you off your feet. Will you still remember my love? So that's where it's great for weddings.
Will your eyes still smile from your cheeks?
Will your eyes still smile from your cheeks? So will you still, you know, love me in many different ways?
Darling, I will be loving you.
So darling, I will be loving you. Till we're 70. So for a long, long time. And you can check out some of the lyrics here. And baby, my heart could still fall as hard as 23. And I'm thinking about how people fall in love in mysterious ways. Maybe just the touch of a hand. Oh me, I fall in love with you every single day. And I just want to tell you, I am. So basically, it's fall in love with you every single day is the theme of this song. And I can imagine this one is going to be played in many weddings in the future. So I'm going to copy that and put that below the video, so you can check that out if you want to learn some English from the number 4 song, Thinking Out Loud. That's the song, is Thinking Out Loud. So it's kind of when you talk to yourself when you're thinking out loud and stuff. Okay, let's move on to the best selling books. So the best selling books in America, and we're getting some of these that repeat because of Christmas time. So we have Grey Mountain, I've covered before, Gone Girl, All the Light We Cannot See, a World War II book, and now the number 4 is Hope to Die. Hope to Die. So, well, we don't hope to die. That wouldn't be good. And, you know, it's a mystery or a detective-based book. So, if you know, we type in what's a detective, you know, that's somebody who, you know, finds the bad guys. So, if I type in detective synonym, a person, especially a police officer, who's occupation or job is to investigate and solve crimes. So you have like a police detective, private detective, investigator, okay, concerning crime and its investigation. And the detective, Alex Cross, is being stalked or looked at or followed by a psychotic genius forced to play the deadliest game of his career. So usually when they say somebody who's psychotic, you know, they're kind of crazy. So if I type that in, I'm kind of scared to almost put it in. It's usually a scary person. Your brain is kind of out there. You're psychotic. Things aren't going well mentally at all. And his family is involved with it. So Cross's family, his loving wife, Bree, the wise and lively Nana Mama, and his precious children have been ripped away. Terrified and desperate, Cross must give this madman what he wants if he has any chance of saving the most important people in his life. Okay. So it's done by, you know, James Patterson, a well-known author who writes detectives and mysteries and criminal type things. So, I'll put that link in as well. You can check it out if you want to learn a little bit from that book. That will definitely help out. Okay. Moving right along. Here in the United States, we had Christmas, and Wiki Travel had a special on Christmas food. And because I love food so much, I thought this would be perfect. So Christmas celebrations, and especially Christmas food, reflect local cultures and traditions. This page lists various Christmas dishes from all around the world. So I hope you enjoy it. I'm just going to double check to see if there's any questions. I think we're doing good. So here in England, roast beef, mashed potatoes, Yorkshire pudding, and gravy. So that's kind of an English Christmas. If we take a look at Finland, and let's just type in Finland just so you get an idea. Finland, where it's located up in Scandinavia. So if I zoom out a little bit, here is Finland. So Christmas at Finland is liver casserole, traditional Finnish food that is eaten at Christmas. So if you're not sure, the liver is, you know, here's like a cow liver. People eat it. My father, he likes it. I'm not too crazy about it, but that's liver. And a casserole is kind of when you mix it up. So we have a liver casserole. Here in France, bouquet de Noël, traditional dessert made from a rolled sponge cake. So a nice little dessert. Germany, Kristallen, is a fruit cake. So that it's bread or a cake with fruit inside. Here's Italy. Raisins. These are raisins right here. So kind of a raisin bread. Lithuania of herring. And herring is a fish. So this fish in Lithuania. In Poland, on Christmas Eve, there are 12 dishes served. So they have 12 different dishes or types of foods. Spain has seafood. In Sweden, glögg, warm mulled wine. So warm wine. Here in Canada, they have meat pies. So pie with meat. Guatemala and Mexico, they have tamales. So these tamales for Christmas. In Mexico, this Chilean nogada made of meat stuffed peppers. And in the United States, we eat a lot. Gingerbread. These are gingerbread house or cookies and stuff. Argentina. Brazil has a turkey. And you can see all the different here in Asia. This I thought was interesting. In Japan, Kentucky Fried Chicken. In the Philippines, a traditional dessert. Australia, pavlova, whipped cream and fresh fruit. And then mince pies in New Zealand and stuff. So I will put this under. So if you want to check out some great Christmas food while we're still in the Christmas season, I hope you don't get too hungry from it. Which takes us to our infographic of the day. 9 steps for saving money at university, or how to save money at university. Basically, when you go to school, you know, how are you going to save your money? Know where your money is coming from and how often. So know about the flow of your money. Try not to dip or go into your savings. So how many times will you go out? You know, are you going to eat out a lot? Protect yourself against shocks. A shock is something crazy. So if we type in shock, you know, to be shocked. A sudden upsetting or surprising event or experience. A blow, an upset, a disturbance, a shock. So to be shocked, you know, that can happen with our money and stuff. Be consistent, so do things regularly. Don't fall into money traps and be tech savvy. So, you know, just little money tips for to save money and stuff. So I will put that down. You can check out some ways you can save a little money. You know, if you have a problem about, I have some friends like that. They love to spend money. That's something you want to avoid. And now this photo of the day comes from my area, spruced up. You know, we have, these are spruces, pine trees. Evergreen trees populate the Maroon Bells Wilderness in Colorado's White River National Forest. So if I type that in to give you some idea, so if I type in Maroon Bells, Colorado. So let me zoom out a little bit so you get an idea. So I live over here in Denver, and so it's down over in this area, probably about 200 miles or 300 kilometers from where I live. And it's in these national forests. So national forest means that it's protected. So you can see White River National Forest. Let me type that in. Give you some pictures. You can check out. So here in Colorado, those are the scenes you get with these maroon bells. Great for camping. You know, wintertime can be crazy. I'll show you that here. So White River National Forest, where they protect the spruce and the evergreen trees and all the things that are there. You can see with the beautiful lake. Let's check out winter, since it's winter time. Well, it's about the same. It's cold here right now in Colorado. So there's a lot of snow in that area. So right over here, National Forest, on a map, you'll see it's all green, meaning that it's protected, that you can't go in and build houses and cut down trees and do anything that you want. You have to be careful with all that stuff. So, you know, come check out the photograph of the day from National Geographic. I'll put that under as well. And then, you know, fun way to learn a little English with that. And to finish it all off here, we have our, from the Merriam-Webster Dictionary, the learner's word of the day, pedagogical.
Pedagogical.
Pedagogical, some say. Pedagogical, pedagogical. Basically, it has to do with education. Of or relating to teachers or education. Pedagogical. So, you know, when you're dealing with, you know, school desks and going to school and everything else like that, that's, you know, comes from that word pedagogical, pedagogical. So let me see if anybody is on Skype, if anybody has any questions, if I got any requests or anything, which I don't think so. And I'm going to set up next week's lesson on my Facebook account, which I'll put that in under this video as well. You can always reach me there. I'll put that on top. Let me type in that. I'll put in the learner's edition as well, so you can learn you know, any new words of the day and stuff. And so I'm going to add a new live event. And I will do that as Learn English from Newest Events and Best Things from the Week. And I'll make that public. I'm going to make it for, here we are, going to go into 2015. Can you imagine that? So it'll be Sunday the 4th, January 4th. If I will put in my Facebook, I tend to check that a little more often. You can click on that. And I will create event. And then when you click on it, it'll say the time, you know, 7 days, no hours, 29 minutes and 53 seconds. And I will post that on my Facebook account so people can check it out. I'll click post. And I'm going to put that on top. I'll put it on top so it remains there. We'll pin that to the top. And then when you click on it, it will tell you the time, the countdown to that stuff right here on my Facebook. Learn English Quickly. You can check it on out yourself. And it looks like... and I'm not seeing any questions. So I think things are going well. Thank you so much for being here. And I will do this again next Sunday. Like I said, I put the time and made the broadcast ready. So hope to see you next week or during this week. This video is stored on my YouTube, so you can check it out when you want. And so, all right, I have a great week, and I hope you learned a lot of English. We'll talk to you later. Take care. Bye-bye.